power.
HP Pavilion Entertainment Notebooks with Intel Centrino Dual Mobile Technology. The computer is personal again.
Sunday is sponsored by Chevrolet, America's brand, Chevy, an American revolution.
Seneca Wallace to Jeremy Stevens for a 15-yard touchdown pass has put Seattle on top 14-10 with 7:39 left in the half. These are the kind of aerial theatrics we're used to having watched these two teams play as division foes the past 4 years as Seneca goes back on the horn.
They've done a good job mixing it up and keeping this Rams defense on its heels, but you know, let's be honest, this Rams defense hasn't played well the last four or five games and not playing well again today.
J.R. Reed starts the return in the end zone. The ex-Eagle is wrapped up shy of the 20-yard line.
Hey, over here.
Why don't you switch to our network?
We're just like them.
Are you reliable?
Excellent question.
How about for email or downloading music?
Why not?
Only one wireless network is America's most reliable for calls, downloads, and emails.
That is a problem, and we are working on it.
Verizon Wireless, it's the network.
Looking for your dream home theater system? Circuit City makes it simple. Circuit City's the place to find Sony, Samsung, Panasonic, and more. Stop by today for a game piece and a chance to win a Panasonic Plasma home theater system. Enter your code at CircuitCity.com for a chance to win great prizes, including a $4,000 home theater featuring a Panasonic 50-inch plasma TV and surround sound system with monster cables and professional installation from FireDog. Only at Circuit City.
Rib lovers, get to Chili's for the best new baby back flavors from around the country. Mix and match any two from five authentic flavors. Two tastes, one plate. Only at Chili's.
I want my Chili's baby back ribs.
What kind of crazy game are you playing?
What movie star has the moxie to infiltrate a new Family Guy?
If she's as ugly as I think, I'll look at her once, and then I'll go bleh all over the place.
It's the ingenious Drew Barrymore.
What is it? One bedroom, one bath?
It's a whole apartment.
Are her parents brother and sister?
All new, followed by The War at Home tonight on Fox. Viewer discretion advised.
Go! Go! Let's go back to the touchdown. Look at Matt Hasselbeck. He sees it before it even happens. He's already saying, we got him, we got him. It's a touchdown. Look at him jumping around. He's as excited as the student there. That's the mentor on one side, the student on the other.
Yeah, which guy's the Pro Bowler and which guy's making his third NFL start? Matt Hasselbeck bouncing around like Will Ferrell in the cheerleader sketch. Digging it.
What, are you trying to start a quarterback controversy in Seattle?
Well, you know, when you look at the yardage that Seattle has racked up in the first half of this game, you would not think that Hasselbeck and Alexander are sitting on the sidelines. Here's Bulger on play action to start the drive. And he's got an open Torrey Holt for the catch past the first down marker, tackled by Marcus Trufant. So this is the offense we're talking about. And what great balance Seattle has struck offensively so far.
They've done very well with the quote-unquote the replacements. Seneca Wallace and Maurice Morris, those guys have been called the replacements. Well, those guys are doing very well and really starting to hit their stride. And the last few weeks they've all been in there playing together, and today they're rolling.
That was the Rams' first down through the air this afternoon. The quick pass to Isaac Bruce. He gets away from one tackler and is finally brought down by Lofa Tatupo. I don't know how he made Kelly Herndon miss. A gain of five.
And that's a winning play for him, because that's just like running the ball on first down and gaining 5 yards. This is just an alert. You can see Bulger looks out at him. He's just going to take one step, throw the ball out there, and then try to let Bruce make a guy miss, which he does in Herndon, and it's a 5-yard gain, and now you're looking at second and five.
There's one for all the veterans, making the young corner miss. Steven Jackson. Between the tackles, tackled at the 41-yard line after a gain of three. Darryl Tapp, the rookie end out of Virginia Tech, making the tackle for Seattle. Third and two. The Rams are converting at just under 39% on third down this year. Bulger with a quick pass underneath. It's caught for a first down. A flag in the backfield as Torrey Holt makes the first down reception for St. Louis. A flag in the secondary, better said.
Holding number 31 of the defense. Penalties decline. Result of play, first down.
Maybe a frustration hold from Kelly Herndon, who we saw got beat a couple of plays earlier.
Yeah, man, but you got to watch the protection. Kelly Herndon, number 31, inside, gets caught for holding on that crosser. But remember, this Seahawk team had 9 sacks last week against the Raiders and really got after them and very aggressive. They wanted to stay aggressive today. They have to be careful in how they do it because the Rams have such good wide receivers. The offensive line has a lot of pressure on them.
Seattle blitzed in 25 of 52 Raider plays on Monday. The underneath pass is caught by Steven Jackson. Bulger and Jackson have made a habit of that kind of connection this year. A gain of 7 on a broken play.
And they come on that play. They blitz from one side, and Chuck Darby almost gets free and gets the sack, but Bulger did a good job of sliding. But they want to continue to stay aggressive. That's John Marshall, the defensive coordinator. Mike Holmgren told us that, you know, I kind of leave those guys alone and let them call the game and the game plan, but I make suggestions to them. He makes suggestions that, hey, we need to get after them. Said he felt like they made a tactical error when they lost to Kansas City by not getting after a quarterback that's not very mobile.
Second and three, and Bulger did not like what he saw. He spends a timeout. The first of the half. Next week, join us for the NFL on Fox. How about the Jets? What are they thinking? Knocking off New England today. At New England, by the way. As the Bears pay a visit next week, many of you in this viewing audience will see Seattle at San Francisco. JC and I will be there for that one. That's the NFL on Fox next week.
How about the Jets today? That upset, like you said, over New England. Man, there are a lot of upsets today. When you look at the league, Kansas City goes to Miami. They get beaten down there. They had been rolling and really put it on both of these teams the last few weeks. Kansas City did and really ran up. Larry Johnson did, ran for a lot of yards against Seattle when they played 2 weeks ago and then against the Rams last week.
Houston beats Jacksonville on the road. Indianapolis just survives Buffalo. They start 9-0 in back-to-back seasons. That's the first time in NFL history a team has gotten off to that kind of start. And you and I have to call each other before we go with this kind of
thing. Yeah, I got the memo. You didn't. You're just trying to look like me.
Just caught me how ridiculous we look.
That's an ugly tie, though.
Second and three for Bulger after the timeout. Up the middle is Steven Jackson, and the timeout was well spent as Jackson has another St. Louis first down.
Steven Jackson was a guy that's turned into a versatile player. He can catch the ball out of the backfield. He can run it with power. You can see he slides back there. He kind of shuffles when he gets the handoff and kind of picks and chooses his holes. But once he gets going, he's a big, strong guy and can make some people miss and run through some people. Steven Jackson's kind of turned into that all-around guy for him.
It's been a change on the offensive line for the Rams as Orlando Pace, the left tackle, is on his way into the locker room. Adam Goldberg has taken his spot. On play action, Bulger with some time. Julian Peterson's coming hard. Bulger gets out of harm's way, tucks it away, and slides safely at the 37-yard line.
We talked about the change up front. Adam Goldberg, he's going to have some trouble here with Julian Peterson. Julian just rips him and comes to the inside and gets up the field in Bulger's face. And Bulger has no choice but to pull it down and try to turn it into some positive yards. But that's going to be the issue. That's how you stop a Torrey Holt. That's how you stop an Isaac Bruce and Kevin Curtis. You got to get after the guy throwing the ball to him.
You saw the Edina, Minnesota native make a good block on that play, taking over for Pace. Kloppenstein, the man in motion. Jackson trying to get around the corner, not so. Nothing doing on second and 10 as Grant Wistrom, the ex-Ram, applied the stop for Seattle.
And they're just out-physicaling the Rams right now, and that's what Kazabinski told the Rams, that the Seahawks don't respect you. They think that they can out-physical you every time they play. And that time, Wistrom just pushed Goldberg back into the offensive backfield and created that loss.
Grant Wistrom having a pretty big day against the old uniform so far. Four tackles for Seattle, and this will bring up a big third and 10 for the Rams.
Now they go with the shotgun to try to give Bolger some extra time.
Has a man wide open. The pass is caught by Torrey Holt. No, that's a first down catch and a gain of 18 yards.
Torrey Holt loves working against Marcus Trufant. He's had success every game they played against him, but he really likes Trufant. Trufant's not a physical guy, though. He's a guy that's going to play off. He's going to try to beat you to a spot. Not going to happen against Torrey Holt.
2-minute warning in Seattle.
Fox NFL Sunday is sponsored by the new AT&T. Your world delivered.
The dream is still alive. Someday it will come true. And this country, it belongs to folks like me and you. So let the voice of freedom sing out through this land. This is our country.
The war in Europe is over.
From the East Coast to the West Coast, down the Dixie Highway, back home.
This America realized the dream of putting a man on the moon. After touching down at approximately 4:19.
From the East Coast to the West Coast.
After 89 years in the making, this is our truck, the all-new 2007 Silverado from Chevy, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
This is our country.
This is Gary Poole, a genial guy from Trenton, New Jersey. Gary's been married for almost 10 years, but until a recent trip to McDonald's, didn't know it. Gary had fresh brewed premium roast coffee with his McGriddles, and it was like he was seeing her for the very first time.
He had no idea we were married.
Gary thought she was cute, so it was okay.
It's like we're newlyweds all over again.
Start your morning with richer, bolder premium roast coffee and add a warm, tasty McGriddles. Wake up and smell your life.
I hope there aren't any other wives.
FedEx presents the Air and Ground NFL Players of Week 9. The New Orleans Saints' Drew Brees completed 75% of his pass attempts for 314 yards, 3 touchdowns, and no interceptions. LaDainian Tomlinson ran 18 times for 172 yards and 3 touchdowns in the Chargers' win over the Browns. Vote for the FedEx Air and Ground NFL Players of the Week at FedExFootball.com.
2-minute warning here in the first half in Seattle with Mark Bulger and the Rams on the move. They are 9 plays into a 61-yard drive, and Mark Bulger has done most of the work in this drive as well. 5 for 5, 51 yards in the air. First and 10 for the Rams at the tip of the end zone. A double tight end set for St. Louis. Hedgecock and Jackson in the backfield. A hand is to Steven Jackson and a flag on the play. Could be another false start charge to the Rams.
Prior to the snap, false start, number 72. Offense, it's still first down.
That's Adam Goldberg, who took over for Orlando Pace. Let's check in with Rob Dazier to see what's happening with the Rams left tackle.
Yeah, the Pro Bowl left tackle went into the locker room with a little over 4 minutes to go in the second quarter. They're calling it a left arm injury. Trainers are evaluating him right now. No word on if he'll come back in this game, guys.
Rob, thanks. Well, it hasn't just been Alex Barron today. 3 false starts by 3 different Rams offensive linemen. Bulger dumps it down to Madison Hedgecock, who hangs on at the 19-yard line and then is swarm tackled right there.
Watch Orlando Pace right here. This is the play that he got injured on, and watch his left arm. Gets that arm extended. You can see right there, as Wistrom was coming around the corner, it looks like that shoulder might have gotten popped out of place, just grimaced in pain.
Seattle has been fantastic in the red zone this year.
No, they've been awful. They've given up 13 touchdowns
offensively
and 19 possessions. They've been awful defensively.
Thank you. Opponents have scored 13 touchdowns in 19 opponents' tries. And that time the penetration came from Wistrom and Terrell. Boy, they had a big game on Monday against the Raiders.
Again, you're going to see Wistrom coming off the edge right there. Just comes and folds back inside, and Terrell's up there, and Wistrom's there, and Davis is there, and that's what they do. Their front four guys are all good pass rushers that can get to the quarterback.
Clock rolling with 40 seconds, third and 14 for Bulger out of a shotgun with a four-receiver set. He has to dump it down to Jackson, incomplete, and the Seattle defense holds. Let's check in with Chris Rose in Los Angeles.
All right, Matt, thanks. JC, your next family reunion is going to be a lot of fun. Reggie Bush, your cousin, scoring his first touchdown from scrimmage. And look at the way he gets it done. Up and over. Give him some extra pretty points on that one. And the Saints have a three-point lead in Pittsburgh. Back to Matt and JC.
Well, it's about time. That's what I told him last week when I talked to him. It's about time you get in the end zone, man.
42-yard field goal by Jeff Wilkins is up and through. So Wilkins gets St. Louis on the board with 27 seconds left in the half. Yeah, you know, Reggie Bush had the most number of touches in the NFL without a touchdown at the start of play.
And guess who's number two? The guy that we have right here, Maurice Morris. The second guy in the league with more touches. Now I guess he's first because Reggie scored.
Well, Fox's football coverage doesn't end when the games are over. Afterwards, stick around for the OT, where Joe, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy bring you exclusive interviews, extended highlights, and a first look at the new BCS standings. It's the OT presented by Lowe's, coming up after football on Fox. And one of the big stories in terms of the BCS has been the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. And in fact, after playing that first ever college football game back in 1869, they probably played in their next most important game just Thursday night. Boy, what a fantastic season it has been for the undefeated Scarlet Knights.
You see their three remaining games. They're Cincinnati, Syracuse, and then West Virginia. Rutgers playing well. Shiano out there has really got those guys going. Craig Versting, the offensive coordinator. How about Rice, the running back?
Yeah. I mean, those. You know, suddenly everybody's from New Jersey, too. Have you noticed that? You know, it's more than just Sopranos fans now.
Bandwagon jumpers, they're everywhere.
Jeff Wilkins to kick it away to Josh Scobie. Seattle will have 27 seconds left worth of offense before halftime. Scobie trying to get around the corner and is shouldered out of bounds at the 19-yard line.
You know, well, look, yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, if you happen to watch anything on Thursday, chances are you channel surfed into Louisville and Rutgers, and Rutgers came back after a big-time halftime deficit, and with some special teams help, they were able to overcome Louisville's big halftime lead to stay undefeated Thursday night.
And that's what college football is about. It's great because all the emotion. Look at the fans. Everybody just storming the field, that emotion. The players were excited. The coach was almost in tears. That's what college football is all about.
Boy, and what is going to happen in terms of the BCS with some ranked teams losing yesterday? That's coming up later. Visa halftime is coming up next. Kurt Menefee, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy will be along with scores and highlights, and the Fox Sports ticker will be rolling with the latest stats. Halftime in Seattle, 14-13. Seattle leads.
Next week on Fox NFL Sunday, the pregame show is on the road and coming to you live from the Meadowlands. Then you'll see Rex Grossman and the Bears brace for a huge showdown with Chad Pennington and the Jets. Or the electrifying Michael Vick and the Falcons in an interconference battle with Steve McNair and the Ravens.
Live from New York, it's the Ford Fox NFL Sunday pregame show next week in HD.
Craving for basketball? Go right to the source. A new and exclusive channel is coming your way on Orbit. NBA TV is your all-access channel for everything basketball, featuring live NBA games, new original programming, and if that's not enough, behind the scenes, NBA news and highlights. All day, all night, all basketball. NBA TV now available exclusively on Orbit, Channel 18.
The Halftime Report is sponsored by Visa, proud sponsor of the NFL. Life takes Visa.
Live from Pittsburgh, it's the Visa Halftime Report. Kurt Menefee, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy. And right now, Seattle owning a one-point lead in one of several good games this Sunday afternoon.
There you go, Kurt. Nice job. A little love right there.
Thank
Carol
you.
Owens, love me some meat. Matt Leinart, buddies in the offseason. Watch Tony Romo, the young quarterback. What a great throw. Man-to-man down the sideline. Romo finds Patrick Creighton. It's Cowboys 10-3 at late in the second quarter. About a minute remaining in that game. Cowboys up on top at 4-4. Now the Saints traveling up to Pittsburgh. Ben Roethlisberger, get those Steelers going, young Ben. Down the middle, deep in. There he is, Hines Ward. Is he going to make it? Pick up a block downfield. There you go. Touchdown, 37-yarder, his sixth on the year. Steelers up 7-0. Ken Wisenhunt, offensive coordinator. Great scheme at the goal line. Beautiful job, execution. There's Miller's touchdown, 14-0 Steelers. But Reggie Bush, we've waited this long, finally. The ninth game of the season, he gets his first touchdown from the line of scrimmage, and it makes the score 17-14. And then the Pittsburgh Steelers have just kicked a field goal, and we with 120 remaining in the second quarter. We all tied up, 17 all.
Well, Howie used to say we about the Raiders. He's happy right now. They own a six-point lead. The Eagles snap a three-game losing skid, bombing the Redskins. The Green Bay Packers win for the third time in four games. Frank Gore with a career day on the ground as San Francisco has won two in a row. Indy wins 14 straight games decided by 8 points or less thanks to today's one-point win. New England loses back-to-back for the first time since 0-2, courtesy of the Jets. Chad Johnson, most receiving yards in the NFL since 2000. Didn't matter. San Diego won big. Steve McNair leads the Ravens to their largest comeback ever, down 19. They score the last 20. Atlanta loses to the Browns a week after losing to the Lions. Miami, a week after upsetting the Bears, knock off Kansas City. And David Garrard threw four interceptions, helping Houston to a three-point win over Jacksonville. All right, Coach, Seattle and St. Louis. All right.
Well, they're having problems with your mic. Seneca Wallace is doing a great job. 30 yards rushing in the first half on two carries, 15 a pop. That opens up running lanes. It forces defensive backs to come off of their coverage, opens things up for Morris. Morris almost 100 yards in the first half.
What people don't know is how he sneaked over there, turned off Jimmy's mic so he could get more air time.
You know what? I'll do anything.
Slow your roll,
right,
Howie. Slow your roll.
Get you all caught
come
up.
Come on.
Visa, proud sponsor of the NFL.
Fox Sunday's a history-making night when the forefathers of comedy return.
I cannot tell a lie. It's freaking sweet.
All new episodes, Homer's AWOL on The Simpsons and Kiefer Sutherland's on The Hunt.
This'll be like shooting cats off of Grandma's sofa.
After American Dad, Drew Barrymore leaves her mark on Family Guy.
Are her parents brother and sister?
And the war at home gets blindsided by a blind date. The forefathers of comedy are back starting at 8, 7 Central tonight on Fox.
The best night of drama on TV is the new Fox Tuesday. First at 8 on a new standoff. Can FBI crisis negotiators stop the king of shock radio?
It is an FM Jerry Springer freak show.
From driving a fan to murder.
Take him off the air.
Don't you hang up. I'll shoot this girl.
Then at 9, it's a new house and it's new time to save a son. House must bring the father out of a 10-year coma.
I could go for a steak.
An all-new house. It all starts at 8, 7 Central, Fox Tuesday. Viewer discretion advised.
All right, we have talked about it. Now time to show you a great surprise Sunday. Roll away, Terry.
What a great day. Let's watch Washington at Philadelphia, Pennsylvania National Guard, the 28th Division in Baghdad, cheering on their Eagles. Watch Clinton Portis in the second quarter leave for the Redskins with a broken right hand. But this day belonged to Donovan McNabb. 20-yard completion, top right of your screen. There's the hit. It passed with the Reggie Brown. Ball knocked loose by Sean Spring. Corral Buckhalter, 37-yard touchdown, 27-3 Eagles over the visiting Washington Redskins. Buffalo at Indianapolis. Manning sets up, good protection, finds Ben Utech. He gets nailed, fumbles the football. Terrence McGee down the side. Get him, Peyton. Get him, Peyton. All right, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it, buddy. 68-yard fumble recovery for a touchdown. We're tied up with the Bills and the Colts 10-all. And then Joseph Addai, the rookie out of LSU, takes it in from 5 yards out. 17-16, Colts over the visiting Buffalo Bills. Jets at New England. Tom Brady. Brady. Play action, sets up, voids the sack, then throws behind the intended receiver, intercepted by Eric Coleman, 10-6 at this point, Jets over the Patriots. Four plays later, though, Chad Pennington to Jericho Cotchery. Great grab, 22-yard strike. Jets take care of New England, give them two losses in a row, 17-14. And then the game of the day, if you like points, Carson Palmer and the Bengals hosting the San Diego Chargers. This pass from Palmer to Chad Johnson. 74-yard touchdown, his second on the day, that is Johnson. 38-28, Bengals over the San Diego Chargers. Then, LaDainian Tomlinson, 2-yard run to the outside, third touchdown on the day for him. 38-35, Bengals over the Chargers. And then LaDainian Tomlinson, a 9-yard touchdown run, his fourth on the day, and a comeback victory. Chargers win 49-41, and I'm talking about one whale of a football game.
And one whale of a day. The Visa Halftime continues right after this.
The biggest race in the world is back. NASCAR returns to Fox with the Daytona 500, February 2007.
هذه المرة ليس هناك فائزون، فقط باقون على قيد الحياة. دوري كرة القدم الأمريكية للجامعات تبث حاليا على أرض ESPN.
Give me your name, demon.
I am Lucifer, the devil in the flesh.
You don't have to tell LJ what Denver, Kansas City means. John and Champ, they know all about it. Herm, he knows. Pat Bowlen, you better believe it. But since it's NFL Network's season premiere of Thursday Night Football, we just thought we'd remind you. Thursday Night Football kicks off Thanksgiving night when the Denver Broncos battle the Kansas City Chiefs. Broncos Chiefs, Thanksgiving night on NFL Network.
Well, the way these two rivals have played in the past, it seems to be who holds onto the football last that wins these games. They've been offensive games. They have been closely played. Today's is no exception. But really, when you look at the first half, Seattle leads by only a point. It's nothing short of amazing considering how many yards they've racked up.
I mean, offensively, they've rolled that entire first half. Maurice Moore, 79 yards, rushing Seneca Wallace, a couple of touchdown passes. And the only way they've really been stopped is that one Leonard Little sack that forced the fumble and a touchdown for St. Louis. And St. Louis offensively just doesn't seem to be in a rhythm. They wanted to come out and establish the running game. Steven Jackson only 26 yards on the ground. And like I said, you take away the one touchdown by Adeyanju, and those guys only have 6 points in the entire first half. So they've got to make some corrections at halftime.
Let's check in on the field with the third member of our broadcast crew, Rob Dazier.
Yeah, Matt and JC, you guys were echoing the thoughts of Coach Mike Holmgren. He says this game could come down to the final possession, so they cannot afford to turn the ball over. Meanwhile, on the Rams side, head coach Scott Linehan says we are giving up too many plays, big plays defensively. We've got to hold them and limit their yardage.
Rob, thanks. And certainly another thing that Scott Linehan will be concerned with for the rest of this afternoon is being without his veteran offensive lineman Orlando Pace, who is out for the remainder of today's and maybe longer with a torn left bicep. Certainly bad news for St. Louis. They've had their share of line problems when healthy, and this is just another thing for them to concern themselves with today.
Yeah, but Orlando Pace is a guy that you don't really replace. He's that good. You fill a guy in that spot, but you don't really replace the production of an Orlando Pace.
J.R. Reed returning the kick that opens the second half, and he is smoked as he crosses the 20-yard line. Oh, man. An angry special teams tackle by Marcus Weeks and Kelly Herndon. Your fantasy update for the latest in fantasy stats, log on to foxsports.com. And as far as this one goes, Seneca Wallace with 136 yards and two touchdowns in the first half. I don't know how many people started Seneca Wallace in their fantasy leagues today, but congratulations to those of you that did.
I did. It's easy to say after the fact, huh?
12th man making some noise to start the second half. Madison Hedgecock in motion before the snap, and the hand is to Steven Jackson, who's wrapped up quickly by Leroy Hill after a gain of a couple. Julian Peterson also there on the tackle for Seattle.
Julian Peterson, he's a very athletic guy. You see him lining up on the edge right there, number 59. He's just going to come, and he's fast enough that he can run down the play from the backside. One of the most athletic linebackers in the league. 100% healthy now. He tore his Achilles when he was at San Francisco, but now he says he's 100% and back to playing like the Peterson of old.
Gain of only a yard by Jackson. Fake the draw, hanging it into the corner for Bruce, and there was really no room to complete that pass as Kelly Herndon had good coverage for the Seahawks.
And that's the thing, when you blitz and you bring guys like Seattle does, you've got to be able to play coverage on the back end.
First half stats have been dominated by the Seahawks. Rushing, passing, total yardage, doubling up on the Rams in the first half today. Again, the Rams don't go three and out very often. Only the Colts have done it fewer times than St. Louis.
Here's the blitz again.
And it gets picked up nicely. Bulger with plenty of time. The pass is complete to Torrey Holt. And with some running after the catch, looks to have a St. Louis first down.
Like I said a minute ago, when you're going to blitz and you're going to bring those linebackers, you've got to play coverage in the back end, and that means man-to-man coverage. You can watch the Tupu. He's going to come inside, and now everybody's singled up on the backside. And when you've got Torrey Holt working on a rookie, Kelly Jennings, you better give that young man some help. Torrey Holt would love to see that all this second half.
Torrey Holt already with more receiving yards at half here today than he had in two complete games against San Diego and Kansas City the last couple of weeks. Off the two tight end formation, Bulger hit as he releases, caught by Isaac Bruce. A first down for St. Louis on a big play, a pickup of 22 yards as Bulger was just able to release that pass before getting hit by Darrell Tapp.
And Tapp was coming around the edge, and look at Bulger just hanging there. You know that clock has to be going off in his head that I've got to get rid of this ball. And that allows just enough time for Isaac Bruce to run that over route and come free.
The first big play of the afternoon by St. Louis, defined as a run of 10 or more, a pass of 20 or more yards. Play action to Jackson. And that one thrown over Isaac Bruce, who was covered by Kelly Herndon.
But you've got to continue to try to get the ball to Isaac Bruce and Torrey Holt like we talked about in the open, because those are your big play guys, and you've got to go to them in a game like this, a must-win situation, even though they only caught. And look at Torrey Holt, thrown two, five times. Look at the catches, five catches. You've got to continue to go to them. If they're not going to stop him, if they're not going to double-team him, he's going to make some big plays for you. You've got to keep going to him.
Isaac Bruce has gone over 13,000 receiving yards with today's work so far. This pass complete to Kevin Curtis, tackled just shy of a first down.
Mark Bulger is helping this offensive line out by getting rid of the ball quick, especially on the three and the five-step drops. And they don't have to be in the long yardage situations. He can throw the ball quicker, get it out of there. That doesn't give the blitz time to get to him. And then their guys have to win down the field.
They do credit Curtis with the first down reception on that last play. Seventh play of the drive coming up. It's covered 43 yards today. Is draw play to Jackson again with a seam up the middle, tackled at the 30-yard line. A gain of 6 on the ground for Steven Jackson before Leroy Hill got to him.
And that's one of the things and one of the ways that you can get the running game going. Most people think you have to run the ball to set up the pass, but when that's not working, you can use the pass to open up the run for you. And they came out, they threw the ball, they got Torrey Holt, Isaac Bruce, got those guys involved. Now that loosens up the defense. They've got to play coverage. Now you come back with the draw, and there's more room to run inside.
The eighth play of the drive. On second and four, Bolger swings it out. That one should have been picked off. Lopa Tatupu, the only Seahawk, the only player in the NFL to pick off Mark Bolger this year. And in fact, Lopa Tatupu scared more than just Rams fans on Halloween, as you can see him again reading this nicely. And that's how he told us he picked off Bolger back in week 6, reading the play.
Well, he's just so smart, and he understands